The gardening season may be basically over, but I know you, and you are planning your next cut flower garden already. So today I'm going to share with you my go-to cut flowers, the ones that look good in bouquets, make everything pull together, and you absolutely must grow in 2022. Hey, I'm Kristen with Shifting Roots, and I help gardeners in cold climates with short growing seasons grow flowers and vegetables with ease. And I have a special interest in cut flowers, which I love sharing with you. If you don't already, quick give this channel a subscribe, a follow, and I'm also on Instagram and Facebook almost every day sharing fun and easy gardening tips. Okay, so let's dive right in to those best cut flowers. So I've been growing cut flowers basically forever, as long as I've been gardening. And I've really developed some favorites over the years. Now, last year was the first year that I actually sold my bouquets for sale. And during that year, I made tons of bouquets, more than I've ever made before. And I really leaned into what my favorite flowers are that just seem to make everything look good as quickly as possible. All right, so in no particular order, here are my 8 must-have cut flowers for 2022, plus one type of flower that you should avoid at all costs. First up, Queen Lime Zinnias. Now, the Queen Lime series is a little bit more expensive than your basic Bernery's Giant or Oklahoma Zinnia series, but I think the cost is well worth it. The first time I grew these, I actually wasn't very sure about them. I looked at them and thought, I don't know if these are all they are cracked up to be. But then you put them in a bouquet and suddenly they just make everything look better. They're really good at pulling in different flowers of different colors that like go together but don't quite go together. And it's like you just throw a queen lime in either blush orange or red and it just suddenly seems to make everything feel better. So definitely on the must grow list. The next for me is Feverfew. Now I gotta warn you, Feverfew has a little bit of a weird smell to it, so it is not for everyone. But I really like the Tetra White variety. That's what I grow. I also grow the lime variety. I find the lime is a little bit harder to use, but I still find that it works well in a lot of arrangements. And I was finally able to get my hands on a single blooming, like the typical looking Feverfew this year. So I will have that in my garden next year, and I'm gonna plant all 3. Love them. They're also a little bit cold tolerant, so it's nice you can put your Feverfew out a little bit earlier, and you can also do a later sowing if you like and get some later blooms in the fall. Next up is Frosted Explosion Grass. Now, I'm really not into grasses, just not my thing. I know they're very trendy, but there's just something about Frosted Explosion Grass. It just is this beautiful, lyrical grass that adds this lovely touch. Anytime in your bouquet when it just feels like a little something is missing, but you don't know what, try some Frosted Explosion Grass. It works really well and looks so beautiful and just goes with everything. Number 4 is cress. Now I gotta admit, cress is a plant that when I looked at the seeds and the pictures for it, it really didn't seem that exciting to me. And I was like, hard pass. But when I saw Monica grow it and she sold me some to try, I was hooked. It is beautiful in all of its stages. When it's younger, it has these lovely little white flowers that work really well with anything. And then when it's more mature, it has these little circular seed pods that just add this beautiful texture, has nice blue undertones to it. The only frustrating thing is that in Saskatchewan, if you're growing it, cress must be part of the brassica family because it really succumbs to flea beetle pressure. So you've got to keep it covered if you're going to grow it. Number 5 is one of my favorites, obviously, and that is amaranth. I love amaranth so much. It looks good in so many bouquets. It comes in coral, pink, green, orange, even a white. It comes in like the more plume shape that are upright. It comes in those really dramatic drooping tails, and you're gonna want some of it all. And this year I made a bridal bouquet with those gorgeous drooping tails, and it was so fun and so dramatic. And if you're a bride with an August or September wedding and you want a dramatic bouquet like that in Saskatoon or area, just call me, DM me. I'd love to do another one. Okay, anyway, that aside, you're gonna love amaranth. you definitely want to plant some. Status was new to me this year, and before I planted it, I've got to admit, I thought it was a little bit boring. Just not that exciting. Didn't really look that pretty, but then I grew it. And I got 3 cuttings from it. The stem length is fantastic. It's a little bit cold tolerant. So status is fantastic. The only thing is if you get the yellow is really hard to work into different bouquets. And with the apricot mix, sometimes it runs like there's a puke color, there's a nice apricot color, and there's sort of a pink color all in that mix. So if you get a lot of the puke color, it's really frustrating. But if you get the other bits, then it's nice. And I don't think there's anything you can do about it. That's just sort of how the mix grows. Next up is straw flowers. Straw flowers are so versatile. You can dry them, you can use them in bouquets. They grow from a good chunk of the season. They're one of the first flowers up of your annual flowers in July. And then they're also one of the last flowers. They're cut and come again. Just so good to have in your back pocket of your garden. Oh, and they're really easy to seed save. So I personally am getting 1 seed packet in every color because I just love them. But if you're only going to try 1 or 2 things, then try the silvery rose or the apricot. Those 2 are my favorite of the favorites. And last but not least is snapdragons. Snapdragons are cold tolerant up to minus 10 degrees Celsius. I personally like to do a late succession of them just because they can last so long into the fall, even though they're more typically thought of as a July crop. But snapdragons come in so many colors. There are 4 basic varieties of them that are good for growing cut flowers. If you're new to cut flowers, just make sure you don't buy the short varieties that are meant for pots. You want to get the tall varieties that are meant for cutting, and you must have snapdragons in your garden. All right, I talked about my favorites. Now let's get to the one type of flower that you don't want in your garden, and it doesn't play nice with anything, and that is highlighter yellow flowers. Highlighter yellow flowers are just so hard to work with. Nothing goes with them. They don't look good with anything. They don't tie anything in. And even if you make a bouquet of just highlighter yellow flowers, which I was very tempted to do, it doesn't look good either. A couple of big offenders of highlighter yellow, that highlighter yellow status, you can get highlighter yellow snapdragons, and some dahlias even tend to run highlighter yellow. So really try to avoid the yellow colorings in those 3 types of flowers. Now with dahlias, there's obviously exceptions. You can get dahlias that are not highlighter yellow, but just beware. All right, so those are my 8 must-grow cut flowers and the 1 type that I absolutely detest. If you want more practical information on growing cut flowers and even starting your own small-scale backyard cut flower business, my course is now open. I'll put a link in the description for that. And in that course, I also plan to share absolutely everything I'm planting, why I'm planting it, what my strategy is behind it. So if you are down for information like that, you're definitely going to want to check with the course and get in on it. All right, friends, I hope you found this video helpful and informative. You can always see me on Instagram, and of course, subscribe if you like this content. We'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.